Hey, I'm Angie.
And I'm Ryan.
And we're
Happy Healthy
Vegan. We're back in Angie's office.
We're going old school with an old school background and an old school topic. Why no onions and garlic?
Yeah, we get this question quite often from you guys. And I can understand. It's been several years since we made a video discussing our beliefs and positions about garlic. So we thought it was time to make a video for you new viewers.
All right.
So let's check out some comments from our two most recent videos. Here, someone says, they love onions and garlic, and please tell me, Ryan, why you don't like them anymore. And this other commenter here asks why you don't have them in Keep It Carbed, Baby, in your recipes.
That's pretty easy, because the one question has a lot to do with the other question. Because Ryan chose not to consume onions and garlic anymore is why onions and garlic aren't in the Keep It Carbed, Baby cookbook. Pretty easy. Keep It Carbed, Baby is just a collection of recipes that I developed for food that we make here on the regular, day in and day out. And since we're not cooking with onions and garlic, it's not in the book. But because I was getting some comments from people saying, why are you trying to take my onions and garlic away from me?
She's not.
I'm really not trying to. So for the next book that I'm working on now, I've actually been talking to Tracy, one of the moderators here on the channel, about the possibility of her testing the recipes and adding in onions and garlic, because she does eat them. And then, you know, she can write down how much onions and garlic, make the recipe taste good for people who like it. So I can add it in as an option for you guys. But the thing is, the whole not eating onions and garlic, like, we never said, you know, we want you viewers to stop eating onions and garlic. And we never said that eating onions and garlic isn't vegan. It's just a personal thing.
Some people have certain physical reactions when eating onions and or garlic, and I have reactions when eating both of those foods, particularly raw onions. Man, you could smell my breath from across the room. And garlic's no better. I have a pretty strong body odor reaction to garlic. I guess most people do, but mine lasts for like 3 days.
Yeah. So yeah, so he wanted to test out what it would be like to not eat onions and garlic.
Yeah, not have those smells follow me around for so long from the mouth and the body.
And guess what, guys? WebMD, when taken by mouth, I guess it's eating, garlic can cause bad breath, burning sensation in the mouth or stomach, heartburn, gas, nausea, vomiting, body odor, and diarrhea.
Does that happen to every single person that eats garlic? No.
But it does happen to some people, and that's why you guys should, like, respect the fact that we have a bad reaction to onions and garlic. So Ryan did it because he didn't like his body odor and his bad breath.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually have finally put it together that I think that onions and garlic were contributing factors to the IBS that I've experienced throughout most of my life. Constipation is another thing that it can cause. Gross, I know, TMI. Garlic can cause eczema. Eczema, guys.
So you've been fighting eczema your entire adult
life.
And you've been vegan, vegetarian that whole time. But
yes,
when you gave up onions and garlic,
yeah,
the eczema went away.
I was actually highly resistant to giving up onions and garlic at first. But the crazy thing was, as we went deeper into omitting onions and garlic from cooking here at home, I started to feel better myself. So I know I literally just talked about how when I gave up dairy, the eczema went away. Mm-hmm. But I mean, I think it's a combination of things. There's this thing called FODMAP. I'll have to put on the screen what FODMAP is. But foods that are most likely to trigger various types of allergic reactions. And onions and garlic are right up there. And when I go through the list of things that you can get from eating onions and garlic, dude, I have a lot of them. So all the GERD and the IBS and the diarrhea and the eczema and the bloating and the gas, handled.
And some viewers, like in this comment here, want us to learn about the anti-cancer, the healing properties that garlic has, and refers to Dr. Greger, which is kind of ironic since I did show Dr. Greger's clips in our prior garlic videos. And these people are saying, yeah, since we're not eating garlic, we're missing out on these anti-cancer properties, and therefore we're screwed. Well, let's see.
The two best families of vegetables for cancer prevention are the cruciferous vegetables, like broccoli, kale, cabbage, and the allium family vegetables, like garlic, onions, and leeks. Cruciferous vegetables in green, allium family vegetables in yellow. So what I want you to notice is the clustering of colors over to the right side, which illustrates the power of these two superfood classes of vegetables, whether for breast cancer, brain cancer, kidney cancer, lung cancer, or brain cancer.
We literally made a video specifically about this Dr. Greger video before, and we addressed the fact that it's not only garlic and onions that have cancer-fighting properties, but the whole group of food called cruciferous vegetables.
As you saw, Brussels sprouts is right there, neck and neck with garlic. Yeah.
We saw that although garlic was named as the number one top vegetable for anti-cancer properties, like having the most effect in the smallest doses, it wasn't the only fruit or vegetable in the world that fights cancer, not by a long shot.
No, like number three, and it was really just marginally beat by garlic, is Brussels sprouts.
We eat Brussels sprouts quite frequently.
Eat them all the time.
Just had them this week.
And just, I think, at number five, right below, was broccoli.
Broccoli. I remember also cauliflower was up there, and we eat cauliflower on a weekly basis. We eat so much cruciferous vegetables. Let's take a look at some of the pictures of our recent farmers market hauls, like just over the last couple of months. Cauliflower, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, kale, even arugula is considered a cruciferous vegetable, and we eat all these things on the reg. People who really view the vlogs and follow us on IG know that we eat a lot of this stuff called khichdi.
It's an Indian dish. I make this all the time around the house. It's full of Brussels sprouts, cauliflower, cabbage, the big three.
Cabbage, how did I forget cabbage?
That's on the list too. That was on Dr. Greger's list.
But it's not just khichdi. I have a lot of other dishes that I make regularly. Mm-hmm. Here's some photos just from over the last 2-3 months. Cauliflower mac and cheese, where the cheese is made with cauliflower, and I served it with some extra broccoli.
I wish I had that right now.
And a classic from the Keep It Carbed Baby cookbook, steamed cauliflower with additional vegetables served over brown rice with a mushroom gravy. A cream of broccoli soup.
That's really good.
Stir fry with a water sauteed broccoli and additional vegetables served over jasmine rice. And there's so many ways that I serve kale, including this recent favorite, Hoppin' John.
Oh yeah, I love that.
Me too. And who can forget kale chips?
So no worries, guys. We're eating plenty of these foods that are filled with all these anti-cancer fighting properties.
Exactly. And you know, just because Dr. Greger hasn't made a video yet about onion and garlic intolerance and allergies doesn't mean it's not a real thing.
That's why I'm shocked when we get these really angry comments from people just trying to shame us for not eating garlic.
Do you guys do the same thing to people that have gluten intolerance?
Or allergies to, like, say, peanuts or nightshade plants.
Mm-hmm. Or things like bananas and avocado. I mean, it's vegan. So,
I know.
You know, as long as we're eating vegan, what does it matter which vegan foods we choose to exclude? It really shouldn't make you guys so angry and, like, rageful.
It's just a few people that get triggered. And as a final side note, it's not like we never eat onions and garlic.
No. In fact, you know, once we started eating in restaurants again, and this was like so many years ago now, and once we started going to vegan events, you know, we realized it's almost impossible to avoid onions and garlic. So thank goodness we don't have an actual allergy where we'd have anaphylactic shock, like a very small percentage of people have. We just have an intolerance. So, you know, when we go out to like eat, drink vegan, and we're eating food out all day, you know, I'll put up with a little bloating and stomach ache and whatnot, you know, I'll get over it. But, you know, when we're making food at home, we just don't bother to buy those ingredients anymore.
So in conclusion, if you enjoy eating onions and garlic, keep eating and enjoying onions and garlic. We're not telling you to stop. We never have.
Never told you not to eat them. Yeah, so I guess hopefully we've answered all of your questions about onions and garlic. But if not, go ahead and leave your comments down below. Pretty much nothing that you could tell us would change our minds about eating onions and garlic, because we know how our bodies feel and how they smell. And, you know, like we said, it's just a personal preference.
But you can share with us your opinions on eating onions and garlic. Do you enjoy them? Do they give you bad body odor? And you care or don't care? Let us know down below.
Oh my God, you're so harping on the body odor. Huh?
That's the worst problem for me.
Yeah, and if you're onion and garlic intolerant, go ahead, speak up.
Yeah.
We want to hear from you as well.
Yeah, leave your voice down there for sure.
Follow us if you aren't already, if you want more vegan content from us. Hit the button if you want to be notified of our next video or when we go live so you can bother Ryan again why he doesn't eat onions and garlic.
Just talking about that little bell up there.
Yeah. And until next time,
keep it carved, baby. Keep it carved. This is stuff we eat day in and day out.
Oh,
such as, let's start off with
bananas.
Oh,
this is bananas.
Take that, Travis Stork. Bananas are cancer fighting.
And when I have my 12 banana smoothie, which shocked the doctors, almost all the time I put in a few strawberries, and they're
on
the list
as
too.
Well.
Cherries, which I love
Your
when they're
favorite.
In season.
Yes. Peaches.
Apples. Ooh.